Hey everybody, Tom Barnes, Chicago Scene, downtown, right on the Chicago River in Van Buren. And if you're not familiar with streets here in Chicago, you know that it is right along the gigantic old post office that is right behind me. Check this place out. Completely rehabbed after sitting vacant for years. And yes, it literally has a highway running right through the middle of it. But this is the patio for From Here On's food hall, where you come out and enjoy yourself. It's like being on a vacation, but the real action's inside this building here. So I'm gonna talk to Sarah about all the fun stuff offered here at this new food hall at the old Chicago Post Office building. All right, so I have made my way inside the grand hall here at the old post office. And if you haven't been in this building, it is fantastic. It is magical. And now there's a new food hall that has opened recently in the last month, From Here On, and I'm talking to my friend Sarah, who can tell me all about it. How are you, Sarah?
I'm great, how are you?
I'm doing lovely. So you guys opened up in June, relatively new, but you have things in this spot that are all about Chicago, down to the snorkel box bar that we're at right now. That's not necessarily about Chicago per se, but what this building was and the purpose was. I don't know, that's what they call the blue mailboxes all over the city.
That's right. That's our little homage to what existed prior to us being here. So this is the old post office, which, as any resident who's lived in Chicago has seen, this kind of in a relatively dilapidated state, and then it has gone through quite a resurgence, a huge makeover. We are adjacent to the historic Grand Lobby, and you'll see there's beautiful furnishings. It's very welcoming. There's lots of bright lights, and you know, it just feels really good when you get into the space. And then here, the food hall is located just a couple steps upward. Yep. And it is basically the landing pad for a lot of folks that work in this building. So it's a lot of commercial tenants that work in here every single day. It's kind of its own neighborhood within the building.
Yeah, I mean, this place is gigantic, but when you come in this space, it's warm, it's inviting. It's like being in a luxurious, gigantic hotel lobby with like all these food options right at your fingertips. But the name of the food hall itself is even something that was carefully thought about. Why don't you explain?
Yeah, definitely. So From Here On, you think about that as, okay, something's happening now, and then what is the plan going forward? So again, thinking about folks that have been in the city before, or even folks that are visiting, you know, this big, massive post office building that goes over the 290, you can think about being on the road, and you know, it's almost like you're driving under it, and the windows are glistening with the sunshine. You come out and it's like, From Here On, it's gonna be awesome. So I'm going downtown, I'm going to the Bears game, I'm going to the Art Institute. And it's sort of this gateway to the city. And then we also did that similarly thinking about post-COVID times, in that a lot of these folks have not been working in this big giant building or having their more of like, you know, normal culture of working. So we were able to bring it back to, you know, From Here On, it's going to be awesome.
Everything's going to be okay.
All that stuff's behind us. We're looking forward to the good things. We're looking forward to community, beautiful places, dining together, small businesses really elevating one another together.
And you did that here by encompassing a lot of businesses from all over the city, mom and pop restaurants, which I think is wonderful. There's no chains. It's mom and pop. You gave them a space to be able to showcase their food. And that's what's happening here right behind you and all around. Why don't you run through some of the options that people have in some of the neighborhoods they're from?
Yeah, definitely. So our goal is always to go around the city of Chicago and find those small businesses, those mom and pops that we know have really fantastic food, have really wonderful people, and really kind of mesh with our spirit of hospitality. So again, it's always going to be community driven. We're not going to see the chains, like you said. So we find folks that we know that represent different neighborhoods. We have a great diversity in our menu selection, and they're just good people that we want to be in the room with, basically. So you'll notice that there's, you know, the more decadent things like the spicy fried chicken from Hot Shy Chicken, maybe a little bit more refined menu such as sweet potatoes and mixed grains and greens from Fair. The family style taqueria, Flo's Kitchen, has fantastic Durango style tacos.
You said that started in a alley in Avondale, like behind where they lived, and now here they are in this magnificent building for thousands of people daily to see what they do.
Yes, exactly. So we found Flo's. We think their food is awesome. We loved kind of the gritty nature of, you know, of the types of businesses that we like to work with and welcome into the food hall. And then operationally speaking, you know, we kind of phrase it as, we take the headache out of operating a brick and mortar. So some folks that say like, well, I don't need to worry about, you know, finding all my different services and all my utilities and all my equipment and all these things that I have to do to start up a restaurant. So that's why we get this really communal, friendly working environment every single day, because of the combination of all of our different energies and efforts kind of overlapping together.
Yeah, you have this wonderful spot where people can kind of hang out and just sit and talk. You got the bar. Tempesta kind of follows the bar, where you have the origins of the drinks that are where they're from. It's like an homage to the old school classic drinks, where it's equal parts. I'll let you explain what the equal parts thing is, because I don't want to screw it up, but it has something to do with the way that they're served.
Yes, exactly. So Snorkel Box, which, should we talk about the name? I'll talk about the name.
Talk about the name.
So, okay, so Snorkel Box, which just sounds like a lot of fun to say, like, yeah, I'm going to the Snorkel Box. But it's actually the name of the blue mailbox that you see on the street corners. So this is kind of our little nod to, you know, the old post office and what came before us. Similarly, on the menu, you'll see that our cocktails were derived from all equal measures. So what that means is, we'll take the classic example of a Negroni, very popular drink. Equal parts of gin, Campari, which is a bitter orange liqueur, and sweet vermouth. And so by having all of those three equal measures of the different ingredients, you can really strike a nice balance. So we took a lot of the classic cocktails that maybe needed a little bit more highlight and a little bit more showcase, and then we kind of made our own spin on some of those as well.
Even that fancy seltzer water you got behind you, right?
Fancy highball, that's
yeah,
a good one.
Thank you.
The crispiest sparkling water this side of the Mississippi.
And then you have this wonderful bakery that wasn't anywhere before. This is their first spot here the food hall, right?
Yes. So Chef Ashley Robinson is a renowned pastry chef. She's fantastic. We actually started a conversation with her quite a while ago, knowing that we wanted her to have the bakery here in the old post office at From Here On Food Hall. She began with a pop-up at Revival Food Hall, a sister company that we have with under the 16 on Center umbrella. So she's been at Revival Food Hall for just a little bit, but this is the home spot. This is the flagship spot for Familiar Bakery. So all kinds of sweets, coming out with some slab pizzas and quiche and some more savory items as well. So really, really good.
And you mentioned the overall company umbrella, where you can purchase some of the things in your little spot over there for
grab and go.
Yes.
Yeah. So From Here On Food Hall is on this elevated plinth right here, but on the ground level entrance. So as you're coming in from the first floor, because this is all publicly accessible, even though it's in a large building that's made up of commercial real estate, this is all publicly accessible. So first floor entry, From Here On Food Hall, we've got the cafe and the grab and go section. So we're working.
You can buy some books and stuff over there.
And then we got books. We got a curbside, as we call it. So we've got some, you know, we're a music company. So
yeah,
some records, some books to purchase. We also have a little community library as well. So you got a bunch of books at home, you want to donate to the cause. We have folks that work in this building every single day that are kind of dropping and checking out as this little self-service library situation.
Sarah, this is fantastic. A fun vibe. You can't go wrong when you have Otis Redding blasting through the speakers in a food hall here. People want more information. What's the best way for them to go about doing that?
They can reach out to us online from hereonchicago.com or info at fromhereonchicago.com as well.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much. I appreciate the time.
Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day.
Absolutely.
See you soon.
Yeah, for sure. That's the Chicago scene here at the old post office. T-B-A-R-N-A-S at WGNTV.com. That's T-Barnas at WGNTV.com. From here on, it's going to be fantastic.